So hello and good evening. This is Ruth Pasula from Curbal.com, and in today's video, we are going to go through the process on how to become more data-driven and how to effectively use your data. Okay? So all that in just a second. I'll be back. So hello and welcome back. In today's video, we're going to go through a standardized process on how to work with data, right? How to become more data-driven and make sure that your data works for you. And one of the things I would recommend, the first thing to do is to define your goals. Don't go and collect all the data just because you have it. Collecting data is very expensive, and perhaps not very expensive to just collect it, but to maintain it. So make sure that you collect the data that you need. And for that, you need to know what your goals are. So you probably have already goals defined for your company. Go and find out what those are and then how they apply to you. So just to make this a little bit more specific, let's imagine that we have as a goal to increase the number of A customers. And for those of you that don't know, you have something that is called customer segmentation, where you can divide your customers into A, B, and C customers, okay? And the A customers if we follow the Pareto rule, it would mean that 20% of our customers stand for 80% of our revenue. So they are our lead customers, the ones that buy the most and bring most revenue to the company. So it would make sense to have that as a goal, right? Let's say we want to increase the number of A customers. Fantastic. Okay, well, you will have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 goals. Don't go overboard, so you actually can maintain those goals and those plans. And the next thing you need to do once you have created your goals, we haven't looked at any data yet. And we're not going to do it in the next step either. The next step is to create a measurement plan. And a measurement plan, it sounds more difficult than it actually is. What it basically does is it breaks down the goal into small pieces. So you can actually start, working towards it. So for example, for our goal, we said that we wanted to increase the number of A customers. One of the things that you need to do is to break that thing into pieces. So what do I need to know to do that? What are the steps or the information that I need to increase A customers? So one of the things that you want to know how many customers you have, right? You go to the ERP systems and you will be able to get that. But you're not doing that. You're not going and collecting any data yet. You just write it. You say, I want to know how many customers I have. That is part of your measurement plan. You say, I want to know how many of those customers are A customers, right? You need to know in order to be able to follow if you are increasing them or not. So how many customers, how many are A customers? And to be able to get more of those, you need to know in a little bit more of detail who those customers are. And that's where things get fun and interesting. So one of the things I would do is say, okay, I want to know more about my customers demographically. I want to know who they are, what sex they are, what gender, what age, where they are located, are they international, are they local customers? And then you write it in your plan. You say, I want to know gender, location, age, right? You continue thinking, okay, the next thing I would like to know is where are they buying behavior? And what buying behavior, I mean, what products do they buy? How often do they buy it? Do they buy very few expensive products, or do they buy a lot of cheap products, but a lot of them? And that is what it meant with buying behavior. What are they buying? Why are they buying it? How often are they buying it? What is the average purchase value for our A customers? And you write it. This is what I want to know. So you're not collecting any data yet. You are not, don't think of data. This is the information that I would like to have in order to fulfill my goal. Another thing is that, okay, if you're going to reach your customers, you know, if you're going to try to increase a customers, you have to reach them. First, you have to know where they are, who they are. You have to know what ticks them, and then you have to know where they are. And that would mean that you have to try to understand, where does this demographic hang out? How do I find them? Are they in Facebook? Are they in LinkedIn? And then you write it, and it's like, I need to know where my customers are. So once I know the demographic and the interests, I can probably start finding, okay, then I need this and this in here and here and here is where those customers hang out. So I can make commercials or visits or conference or whatever it could be. Okay? So that is our master plan. That at least in the Lean Six Sigma, it's called a measurement plan. So we have a measurement plan, and now we have to, in our measurement plan, is we need to say, okay, we need to know how many customers. Where do I get that data? And it says here in the spreadsheet, why not? It says here, okay, I need to get it from my ERP system. How do I know the demographics of our customers? Either you have that, or there are, you know, apps and plugins and services that will allow you to know that. We're allowed you to, for example, know which sex they are. We're allowed you to know the gender, will allow you to know all these things that you need to know. And you're right, okay, I need to buy the service to get that data. Should I do it or not, depending on cost? And that is another thing, but you say, this is what how would I learn about their interests? Maybe if they have Facebook's accounts, I could go there and grab that data from their buying behavior, your ERP system, right? That's where you'll get where they buy it. Probably your website, if you have web information. And not only if you have web information, you know, like a web shop, you probably will learn a lot from how are they looking at your pages, which pages are they going in, and all that stuff. So you say, I want to know website, ERP, I want to have data from Facebook, from LinkedIn, from my website. And that is your plan. So once you have that plan, then you start going into the different sources and pulling the data. But now you know which data you need to pull, so you don't need to pull everything. You say, I want this from here, this from there, this from there, this from there. And once you have everything, you start, you know, the Power BI work. You start collecting your data and measuring it. You start creating your measures, you create your model, you create your visuals. And you start gaining insights that probably will force you to go back to the measurement plan and do some changes. So like, oh, that was not what I thought, so we need to. But that's fine. You will go back and forth in that process just to find, once you're getting insight while collecting and measuring the data, right? And once you have everything, you will say, okay, my customers are male, they are middle-aged, they hang out on Facebook, they have LinkedIn accounts, so I'm going to create a campaign and they buy product A and they buy it once a month. So you go into Facebook and then you do a campaign on that. Easy, right? So that is the easiest way to actually just start using for real your data, and the data helps you. And you might think, okay, I'm done. Yes and no. You are definitely starting to be more data-driven. What you need to do now is what in Lean Six Sigma world is called the DMAIC process. It is called defined, measure, analyzed, improve, and control, right? So now we have our first campaigns out, and then you start collecting data from that again, right? Now you're starting the process again, but from your action plan. And then you start to measure that again. You start measuring, for example, Facebook data. Say, oh, how am I doing? Am I getting new customers? You get that from your ERP. And are those customers from, you know, coming from the Facebook campaign that I did? There are tons of ways to know, to not to connect these two together. And once you start knowing that, you might, you know, you have to measure things and say, okay, am I getting the right customers? Because you might be getting a lot of customers, but they are B customers and not A. And then you will have to start doing some analysis and say, okay, I am collecting this Facebook data. Am I measuring this? Am I analyzing it? And I'm not getting A customers, I'm getting B customers. And then you might realize that, oh, is because A customers buy A products, but they come because they see a B product. So I have to do an announcement on B product, and then they will buy an A product, which is a better quality. But they will not buy an A product if I don't do an A, you know, for example. So you need to continue. That is a continuous process, right? Once you start collecting data, you get your actions, then you start measuring, and you measure, analyze, improve, control. Control means, is it still working the way we want? And if it's not, you define, you have to redefine, like we did. We said, no, it shouldn't be a Facebook ad on product A, it should be on product B. And it's, if you can, it's fantastic to do A-B testing, because then you will know right away. You say 50% will see product B, 50% will see product A, and see who gives you most. But that is a little bit more advanced, right? So those are the steps that you need to take. It's actually very, very easy. Define, measure, analyze, improve, and then control. Is everything working the way we want it? And if it's not, you redefine. If it is, you measure, continue measuring. And that's the way you'll get your data work for you the best way, in my opinion. So what is the process that you use, and what do you think about this process? Love to hear it. Yeah, I've been talking for quite a while now. So I'll see you again on Wednesday. And in the meantime, take care. And always, Spain went out from the World Champ, from the World Cup. But I'm still watching other teams. So yeah, take care. Bye.